Concorda, in the time I have, I will be brief on the subject and mention the realities of the department's transition from a generalised education allocation model for learning supports education at primary and post-primary school to the revised allocation process we have today. The former dealt with the assessed needs of individual children, while the new model allocates special education teachers to mainstream schools based on the profile needs of the school. While this works in some way for children who display so-called high incidence educational, it is not working for those with multiple diagnoses or complex education needs. They fall between the cracks when a mainstream school cannot support them and where the nearest special school can be up to a four-hour round trip away. This is the reality facing a child whose mother has come to me in utter frustration of the lack of progress in their daughter's education situation. Despite the fact that she is unable to cope at the level of many children who themselves have autism spectrum disorder, the department has classified her as having a mild intellectual disability. Her multiple diagnosis requires supports for her behavioural, emotional and intellectual difficulties, which were not provided for by the mainstream school due to the lack of training and available educational supports. This mother has been asked by the mainstream school to keep her child at home for certain activities until her parents made the difficult decision to move her to a special school. The department's new model did not look at the way the school could be better resourced to cater for the child's educational needs, and instead the only option was one that was not ideally suited and which has led to the long travel involved, which has exacerbated some of her problems. Ideally, schools not only need more resources to address the educational needs of individual children within the community so they can integrate into mainstream schools, and if it can't cater to certain individual children, the government must make provision for special schools or special classes accessible within the local community. While I welcome this motion, I do feel that more needs to be done for those with complex educational needs and for children who consistently fall between the cracks left behind by the department. Thank you.
Thank you, Deputy Pringle. Now, deputies. Yeah.